Ownership of shares in a single company can be risky. The company may suffer poor financial results, causing the stock price to fall. The risk of losing money in the stock of a single company can be reduced by simultaneously investing in the stocks of several different companies, especially when they are in different industries. One way to participate in the profits of successful corporations but reduce the risk is to purchase shares in a mutual fund that invests in stocks. A mutual fund receives money from many different investors and uses the money to purchase stocks or bonds in many different companies. Most mutual funds are actively managed, meaning that managers are paid to buy and sell stocks that they think best for investors in the fund. Most of individuals' investments in pension plans are invested in mutual funds or some sort of stocks. An example for looking at mutual funds, say a $1,000 investment in a typical mutual fund that owns stock means that you own a very small piece of perhaps 100 different companies. In terms of the stock market, historically the stock market have usually had a great return in investment, much better than savings accounts, CDs, and bonds. The payoff is stock markets over a long term, 20 years, stand to gain. Looking day to day can be quite disturbing, looking at the rises and falls of the stock market. However, long-term investments gain much better historically over savings accounts, CDs, and bonds, but there is risk associated with it, as we just said. Perhaps spreading that risk through the purchase of mutual funds is better than in individual companies, whereas savings accounts, CDs, and bonds are guaranteed. They have the FDIC, Federal Deposit Insurance Corporation backing, but at a much lower return. Most financial planners agree that stocks should be part of any long-range investment plan. Let's take a look at the difference between putting money, say $600 every 6 months for 10 years into a CD that yields 5% compounded semi-annually, or purchasing blue chip stocks that hopefully will yield 8% compounded semi-annually. We can see right now 8% rate versus a 5% that this will pay off more. In today's economy right now, lucky to have a 2% CD rate, whereas the stock market can be yielding 8%. But let's do the math. Because it's compounding, we need to find the interest rate per compound period. It's semi-annually, so we take our 5% divided by 2. Number of compounding periods twice per year for 10 years is 20. Looking at a future value table, multiplying that regular deposit in 10 years, this is what the account could grow into if the money was safe and secure in a certificate of deposit. And keep in mind, again, today it's virtually impossible to find a CD that's paying that kind of return. Whereas the stock market is still returning an average of 8%. To calculate its value, we'll take the interest rate divided by 2 because of the compounding frequency per year, giving us a I value of 4%. Total number of compound periods twice per year times 10 gives us 20. Looking that up on our future value compound interest table to find the multiplying value times it by the regular deposit, and you can see that we have a difference of over $2,500 between the two. Caution though, day trading is not the best practice when investing in the stock market. The guaranteed return is when the investment is in over a long period of time.